There is an experiment called learned helplessness. In this experiment, researchers prepared a big box. They put a dog in the box and gave it an electric shock. The dog could stop the electric shock by pressing a lever. These dogs learned to help themselves by pressing that lever. Then they had a second group of dogs. These dogs were given the same electric shocks, but pressing the lever did nothing to stop it. Later, both groups of dogs were put into another big box. This time, they received the electric shock. They could escape it by jumping over to the other side of the box, which didn't have the electric shocks. Strangely, the second group of dogs did not do so. They just continued to receive the electric shocks. They learned that no matter what they did, nothing would stop the shocks. So they just continued to receive it. And here's how a cult will use this knowledge to take advantage of you. They will tell you that you need help and God is there to help you, but only they can show you how to tap into the power of God. Only they know the secret of God's divine power to help you. Do you see what they are doing? They are making you helpless and dependent on them. It does not matter if they have good intentions or not. The fact remains that they feed you with thoughts of helplessness, and only they have the solution to save you. Have you noticed how some churches advise their members to always pray before making a decision, or to seek counsel from the pastor before a big decision? Why don't they teach the members decision-making skills? Managers all over the world are taught this skill. This skill can be learned, but churches tell their members to pray about it. They are taught to rely on an external help. In the end, no decision is made, or a decision is made too late. I have seen too many Christians who missed an opportunity because they did not know how to make a proper decision. How many times have I seen Christians who do not venture into something new because they are too afraid of the future? How many Christians are single because they are still searching for the right mate? How many Christians simply obey the church leader even though they are unsure of his advice? Oh, I better just follow what the pastor said lah, in case I'm wrong. All these problems stem from the state of helplessness. These people have been told they are helpless and need guidance. They are told they don't know any better. They are told they need help. They even sing such songs in church. I'm nothing without you, Lord. I need you, Lord. They become so helpless that they become dependent on the church. Remember the experiment with the dogs? Well, the researchers tried to teach the poor dogs from the second group how to stop the electric shocks. The dogs were given treats to reward them for jumping over to the other side of the box. But that did not work. Then the dogs watch how other dogs from the first group escape the electric shocks by jumping over to the other side. But strangely, the dogs from the second group did not follow the example either. In the end, the only way to show the dogs how to escape the electric shocks was to physically carry the dogs over to the safe side of the box. And the researcher had to carry the dogs over twice before they realized that there was a way out of that ordeal. This means that if you are one of the people trapped in an organization where you feel helpless and dependent on the organization for help, someone needs to come and physically save you. If no one comes to help you out there, you will probably be stuck there forever. If you have doubts about your organization, whether religious or otherwise, stop and ask yourself, are people outside your church warning you about the organization? Do you have doubts or questions about the church leader? Can you resist if they went against your conscience? Are you able to step away from the church to think about it without being pressured back into the fold? Do you only feel safe inside your church and told that you have to be protected from the outside world as evil? These are good questions to consider all the time. A good church or organization allows people to grow slowly and be better people. It helps them be better people inside and outside the church. It does not seek to control its members. It does not take advantage of them, like expecting them to devote time or money to their program. A good church does not exert authority over its members. If your church does this, you are in a cult.